morning. I'm JaNee Boston, an English teacher at Henrico High School. We are in English 12, Advanced Placement Literature and Composition. This is my wonderful second block class here, and our lesson is on digging deeper into literary elements. We are finishing up our reading of Shakespeare's play Othello, so we're getting ready to disrupt the text, bring it into their real world. We're gonna listen to some music, we're gonna talk about love, theme, and how major literary elements make up the meaning of the work as a whole. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. So you have three hearts on your desk. Three hearts on your desk. And like, what's today, guys?
Valentine's Day.
Right? And I just think it's perfect that like Othello is ending on Valentine's Day. Like there's some level of cruel irony that we're gonna finish talking about that. So the first thing on any, I don't care what color, I don't care what size, whatever you picked, I want you to tell me love is blank. Love is blank. Just tell me what love is for you. This is gonna be kind of our attendance, our entrance ticket into the theme of love. Love is blank. Love is blank on your first heart. Ooh, I need to do one. Oh, y'all took all the pink? I can have your pink, Gabe. Thanks. You, what color do you want? You want an orange one? Thanks, Gabe. Thanks. Sharing is caring, Gabe. Love is blank. From your perspective. Ooh. Are we stuck?
Yes.
Oh. Oh. Complexity in there. I love the fact that some of you wrote like one word. Some of you wrote like a paragraph. Some of you are like, I need my biggest heart ever. Some of you are like, I want the smallest heart ever. I gave you no instructions, so thank you for taking it wherever you needed it to go. Anybody want to share? Love is? Cam.
Reassurance.
Reassurance. Love is? What do you have?
Trust and care.
Trust and care. This side, what do you have?
Joyful, amazing, environment, sometimes toxic.
Oh, some complexity. So we have all of these positive attributes, and then you added in a level of negativity. Austin?
Intense.
Intense. Love is?
Carrying and pushing forward even through tough times.
Tough times. Raising. Oh, Cameron.
Stressful.
Nadia.
Work.
Raise your hand if your tone, your attitude towards love is more positive. Okay. Raise your hand if your attitude towards love can be seen as more negative. Is that like your personal experience? Okay. Raise your hand if you're like, I'm just stating facts. I don't want you to know any of my personal business, Ms. Boston. This is just... So, step one, we are the authors of our story. So, have y'all seen Dr. Andrews's board, Love Is, next door?
His wall.
His wall. So these are going on his wall. So we are helping him finish his window. But now we need to get into what an author would say about their theme. So, is love in Othello?
Yes.
Positive or negative love?
Both.
I feel like at the beginning when him and Desdemona's relationship first like started out, that was like pretty positive between the two of them. But then when like all the stuff started happening, that's when like the negative love and like the jealousy.
Yeah.
So, love led to
jealousy.
So, what do you think? What are you saying? Positive?
I mean, I agree with it, like Malachi said, it started out like positively and then ended a certain way.
What do you have?
I feel like the relationship, like in the start, they both loved each other, but then after all the rumors, Desdemona still loved Othello. There was no toxicity from Desdemona's side to Othello's, but on the other hand, Othello like lost her trust of her and just in a way, like, lost how he used to be so obsessed with her, and his whole life was just about Desdemona, but now he feels like he doesn't really care what can happen to her.
Well, is obsession a level of love?
Yes.
What do you got? Go ahead, Alpha.
When Desdemona, like, got dead, and then she came back, she told Amelia that no one murdered her, that she killed herself because she loved Othello so much, and she believed that the reason why he killed her was because it was her fault. She was blinded by her own love for him, that she didn't see anything was going on with him. So more of, it's really powerful, and it ended up starting as a good thing and then just falling downhill.
Because of the power?
And yes.
Okay.
I think it was like when it started at the beginning, like Desdemona and Othello were kind of a team. Like they knew that they were breaking a rule by being in love with each other and wanting to get married, but they kind of agreed to just defend each other and go through with it anyways. But then as the play went on and Othello kind of got distracted by what like Iago was saying and the rumors and everything, Othello kind of shifted to wanting to possess Desdemona instead of like being on a team with her, which I think is also why he didn't really consult her about any of the rumors and just started accusing her of things. So I think he kind of shifted from working together to possession, and that's why it ended.
And there's definitely another theme that we're going to hit on is this possession of the female body, right? Like of the female spirit, of womanhood, of all of that. What do you have, Lee? And then we're going to disrupt this text.
I think that's really strong in this play, or in a lot of plays like of this time period, like, or just in certain religions, or just in certain like entities, that like having control of your wife is what the deal is. You need to be in control of your wife, or you're not in control of your marriage, or you're not in control of your household. Because I know from like personal experiences, if like it was either control or it's not my way, it's not going my way, I don't like this anymore, or blah blah, or you let me control you, you let me tell you what to do, and all is well.
Is control in this play?
Yeah.
Do people use love to control?
Yes.
Okay. So we're going to disrupt this text, okay? So to disrupt the text, we know Shakespeare was written by, like, let's just call a spade, an old dead white guy, right? Are any of you old dead white guys?
No.
No. Do you identify with this play? Kind of. Are there some parts, are there some themes? Clearly, I think the theme that a lot of us would attach to would be love. And no?
Oh, like my overall thing was like trust.
Ooh, yeah. Is love close to trust?
Well, yes.
Yeah, we're going to talk about, when you did your Actively Learn, you guys talked about trust and jealousy a lot. So we're also going to hit on those. But I mean, I had to talk about love today. Because it's Valentine's Day. All right, so we are going to listen to the edited version of Kill Bill by SZA. Yeah?
Yeah.
It needs to be the edited version. You have the lyrics, and we're going to practice annotating, right? So we can already tell, have you heard the song before?
Yeah.
Yes? No, maybe? No. A few times? What have I already told you the topic is going to be, like based on what we're talking about today?
Love.
So I will write that on my paper. We know we're looking at love. What is our anchor text? What are we trying to compare it to?
Othello.
Othello. So I would write down that we know that we are connecting this piece to Othello. How is it similar? How is it different? We're looking at word choice, the way the author does something, right? Because we're looking at elements. Whenever we look at a text, let's bring it back to lit class. We've had a lot of great personal discussion. The purpose of analysis is trying to look at how the small pieces develop a whole. So you are going to read and annotate. Think about what words stand out, what literary devices are used, and then how do they develop the meaning of the work as a whole. Ready? Up.
Oh, I do know this song.
It's a part of it. One more minute. Get your thoughts out. All right, where do we want to start? Who wants to start? Something that stood out, question, comment, concern, idea? Cam.
When she said, if I can't have you, no one should, remind me of, you know, like, Othello murdering Desdemona because he thought she was being unfaithful.
Absolutely. So stanza two, if I can't have you, no one should. So that should immediately bring you into Othello and Desdemona, right? Like, Othello was to this point where, like, if I can't have you, you have to die. Armand.
When, like, just, like, six lines where she says, like, I did it all for love, I did it all on no drugs, I did all this sober.
Uh-huh.
It represents how, like, people think, people do crazy things on drugs, but the actual reality is love is what drives people the craziest. And that shows, like, how Othello still loved a part of Desdemona, but that's what drove him so crazy, like the rumors about Cassio, which made him want to kill her.
So, Armand, good question. Love is the craziest thing, or is love the drug, or is rumors the drug?
Would the rumors have affected him if he didn't love her?
Ooh, would the rumors have affected if he didn't love her? According to this, according to SZA, what is the drug?
Love.
Love, right? In Othello, what do you think the drug is? Could it be, could he, guys, pause, PSA, drugs are
bad.
Bad, okay, drugs are bad, okay? Is Othello on a drug?
Yes, power.
He's on a, ooh.
He's on a power trip or something.
Or something? Who's?
Jealousy.
You don't think it's a power trip? Who's on a power trip?
Iago.
Now you got it. Now you got it. It just came to you, right? It just hit. So, does there have to be an outside influence to make you do something that maybe isn't rational?
Yes.
No.
Because, like, jealousy and love are, like, inward motivational things.
Yeah, and your internal thoughts continue.
But then, if nothing, like, if something outside of you doesn't happen, then those emotions wouldn't come out.
Yeah, but then, like, you internalize so many things regardless of what people say. Inside of yourself, you battle with yourself over stuff that nobody else knows about. So it's like, if you really think about it, it could be internalized. It could be the fact that he just internally raged so much that it just outwardly projected because, you know.
I mean, in Othello, Iago's the one who's, like, telling him all the rumors and stuff, but Othello is really the one who, like, works himself up. Like, Othello's the one who's like, we should kill Desdemona and Cassio. Like,
yeah.
Iago kind of gave him the reason, but didn't give him the idea to just start killing people. So I think it's, like, that combination of the things you see or things you experience outwardly that build up the inward.
What you got, Cam?
I was just gonna, like, agree with Nadia because Othello was just, like, straight out, like, how are we gonna murder them?
Guys, drugs are
bad.
Murder is
bad.
Okay, good.
Also, like, what...
How many got our mind?
Also, like, what Nadia said, like, it also happens, like, when SZA's singing, like, you can see all her internal thoughts, like, she's talking to herself, like, she's saying she's mature, she's saying, like, she thinks it's a lost cause, so... She, like, the breakup with her boyfriend is not what's affecting her as much, but it's actually her, like, talking to herself about, like the breakup and what actually happened and, like, reassuring herself that it's not her fault.
It's this self-talk, right? And we know in Shakespeare, we're going to get self-talk through soliloquies. We're going to have their monologues. And this self-talk is powerful, right? We know Iago depends 100% on talk, right? And then Othello's talking to himself throughout the piece as well. Cam, what do you have?
The first line, when she said, I'm still a fan, even though I was salty, it made me think of how Desdemona was like,
yeah.
Like, I still love you, but I don't deserve this. I don't know why you're treating me like this. And she, like, stood by the fact that she killed herself because she wanted to protect.
In the end, is Othello still a fan of Desdemona?
Yeah,
he is, isn't he? Like, this line works for him. Like, he still loves her even though he's hurt, right? What about, go to 1, 2, 3, 4, stanza 4. The text gonna be evidence. This text is evidence. What does that connect to? What do you have?
Iago and Othello. Othello's hiding, and Iago got Cassio to speak, and that's like how in the line, "Now I'm in amazement," playing on the patience. Like, he was amazed at what, like, the conversation showed as proof. So then, like, after that, that's when he really kind of lost his reason or, like, ration, and he was just like, "Let's kill him."
He had this moment of proof, right? Does SZA need proof?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, what do you have, Cameron?
Like when she said, "I tried to ration with you, no murders, no crime of passion." That's like, that kind of reminded me like when Othello like flipped and he was like, "Yeah, I'm just gonna go kill her."
Hey, and then, good luck, homie. You got this. He's getting ready to take his IV test.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Woo! That probably made it worse for you. But yeah.
The line, "I tried to ration with you, no murders, no crimes of passion, but damn," like, that also kind of attests to, like, Desdemona and, like, how she wanted to kind of, how she kind of was rationing with him, but he just wanted to kind of kill her and kind of just, like, dismiss her from whatever his situation was, which, like, goes to the point that Cameron was talking about when she, like, killed herself.
So, let's look at some of the features. There's a lot of repetition, right? Which makes sense for a pop song, that we know there's gonna be a lot of repetition. But I wanna look at the way in which there are repeated lines and it shifts. "Rather be in jail than alone," but at the end, what does SZA say?
"Rather be in hell than alone."
Mm. So we've had this shift, right?
Because before she was just like thinking about doing it, and it's like, attempted murder, like, yeah, you're gonna go to jail, but like, if you really talk about like actually killing somebody, isn't that a sin? So
we have this level of morality here. For those of us that have finally gotten through all of it, we know that technically Othello is arrested,
but then he kills himself.
And then if we're thinking about morality during that time, what is gonna be the piece? So I need you, take a moment. On your heart, from SZA's point of view, not your point of view, what does SZA think love is? According to this song, love is what? And find one piece of textual evidence to support your claim. Love is what? Thank you for joining our class.
Happy Valentine's Day!